Thank you all for being here, and I just once again apologize for the delay. See, this film is a very important film in my career. The reason being, it's a journey ever since I saw this film, Enter the Dragon, when I was in college. A huge influence of Bruce Lee in my life, and I wanted to catch his thought process somewhere in some time, whenever I get the chance. But since India doesn't have many martial arts culture, and very difficult to find a very accomplished martial artist. And after that, I needed a certain character, like a female martial artist, which is even more difficult for the obvious reason. And then, martial art as a subject itself is very rarely taken up. Most of the time when we see action in films, there is VFX work, there is CG, there is dupes, and there is, clever editing, which most of the time the actors actually don't know martial arts, whereas Pooja is actually a real martial artist. She's a Taekwondo champion. She's been working in martial arts practicing since the age of 12 or maybe lesser. And then I got trained in what's called Jeet Kune Do, which is founded by Bruce Lee himself. So it is that underlying thing which I thought will make a very, very difference in the visual aspect of when you see a fight. And every fight in this film is basically something she can do herself. There's absolutely, like I said, no VFX or dupes used. And there's a very kind of a strange love story involved. Like when she's in love with Bruce Lee, obviously the spirit of Bruce Lee, and the boy is in love with her. So there's a triangle of that set against the martial arts. I just want to introduce the basic concept of the film. And once we finished test footage and I sent it to China, it's sort of a production company, and they were so impressed with whatever they saw, and they came down. And I was surprised myself, because China is the mother of martial arts. Everybody from Bruce Lee to Jackie Chan to Donnie and everyone came from there. In spite of that, they thought Pooja was incredible. So that is when it became an Indo-Chinese production. And now it is releasing in China on the same day, on July 15th, in more than 40,000 screens. So I think it's an accomplishment. Whatever we had is in terms of what I started my journey as a Bruce Lee fan to me making a film on Bruce Lee and that releasing in the home place of Bruce Lee, which is China. I'd like you to show a video of India Meets China. Yeah.
Hi Pooja, first of all.
Hi.
How glad are you to be here in Bengaluru? And being a martial artist, how did you feel when you got the call from his team?
I'm extremely glad that I got to come here. And I was really excited to visit Bangalore. Oh my god, so many cameras. I thought sirf RGB sir ke set pe itne cameras hote, but I can't even count. I'm sorry guys, we were late. We lost sir's bag, and then after a lot of drama, we finally reached here. But let's talk about the real drama. How did you guys like the trailer? It was good?
Yes.
Fantastic. Come on, some
noise.
Some noise. Okay. So, hi everyone. Namaskara. I am Pooja Bhalekar, the Hudugi. I guess I'm pronouncing the word rightly. Let me tell you something about myself. I started my journey as a yoga yoga student, and after some time, you know, I saw a couple of kids performing very interesting moves on my school ground, and I went ahead and asked that coach that, you know, so what is this sport that you're teaching? So he said that this is self-defense. We call it like, you know, Taekwondo. So I went ahead, I told my family that I want to join this martial arts class, and I started from a very small tournaments, district level, state level, and then on national level. And I have represented India in Asian Games and many more international tournaments. And I have received a Lifetime Achievement Award from the Maharashtra government. And I'm a second dan black belt. And I have 14 years of experience in Taekwondo. So after all this, I got a call from sir's office that he's looking for a girl who can perform martial arts. So I went ahead with my dad and met sir at his Mumbai office and gave him a small demo of whatever I could learn of all these years. So sir was very happy with the performance and he said that I've been looking for a girl past a year and maybe more than that, and I think that search has ended when I met you. So that moment was very special in my life, and I'm very grateful that I've got opportunity to work with RGV sir. I'm a huge fan of Bruce Lee and I'm a huge fan of RGV sir. So I have two gurus in my life that I look up to and follow their lifestyle and the way of thinking. So I'm really excited and I'm really, really happy that Ladki is finally releasing on July 15th. So I invite everybody to come to the theaters and watch this wonderful, wonderful film. I'm sure everyone will love it. Thank you.
And of course, you have done a wonderful job, Pooja. Now I request you to have your seat. Thank you.
I think there are three elements to it. One purpose I feel is, like I already mentioned, it's like my obsession for Bruce Lee. And why it was, because he symbolized a certain perfection in terms of a human body actually can achieve this kind of an expertise in flexibility or movement of the hands and legs. Everyone has that, but to make it into an art form, which is what I thought Bruce Lee managed, which is why he's become an iconic figure over so many decades, and can't forget. So I wanted to capture his thought, like a 5'7" man can actually make you believe he can beat up 20 people who are probably higher, larger than him in terms of weight and height. And I thought I will take that thought a little more further and make it into woman. A woman generally is considered as a weaker sex. She is easily intimidated, she is easily, harassed and whatever. So the self-defense aspect of even a woman, if she is determined, how strong she can become is my point.
And there is a mistake in Kannada version. Huduki title, we have this tagline, Enter the Girl Dragon.
Yeah.
There is a spelling mistake, please get it corrected.
Enter the Girl Dragon has a spelling mistake?
Yes, in Kannada version only. Please get it corrected.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. Yeah.
This movie started before the Galvan Valley incident or after the incident?
No, Gangnam Style incident happened just, I think, recently, no?
2020 May.
Okay.
After that, Indochina, there are some...
Actually, you're talking about that, sorry, yes, just got missed. It started much before, actually, 2019,
Were there any problems when you went to China to shoot the movie?
Not really, because I think those problems are primarily more political and more kind of bilateral issues. Most of the time, the trade was going as it is, and even the COVID time there was a lot of cooperation between the countries. And this film's subject matter is not about relationship between the countries and what we think or what they think. It's more to do with a homage to Bruce Lee, who is an international figure.
During all this shooting, are there any dupes used or completely...
No, absolutely, it is Pooja's own stunts, because that was one of my, maybe the most important requirement I had, because I didn't want to use normal feature film techniques of using dupes and VFX and creating body doubles and all that. Since she's a very proficient martial artist herself, there was no need to use dupes, and that's also the requirement.
Bruce Lee fan film,
I'm not sure I understood the question. This is,
fan.
Yeah. Yeah, she's playing a Bruce Lee fan in the film. Yeah. She's like a Ekalavya Shisha, like, you know. Yeah.
It's like become a Hollywood movie, right?
I think the one main reason, because in India, have you never seen an Indian face actually in a martial art kind of, a very proper martial art film, you know? And since Bruce Lee as a concept itself is well known, which is the reason why it is having such a wide release in China in 40,000 screens. So I think more or less it will be taken step by step in stages to every country. I think they're doing both in Chinese language and also dubbed with subtitles.
That's
a beautiful question, actually. Yeah? He's saying if Bruce Lee was alive, would you make the film with him or you? I honestly think I'll make it with Pooja. Because maybe I like women more than men. Or probably with both of them as hero and heroine. No, no, she was originally a martial artist. Her basic training was in Taekwondo almost when for more than 14 years before I met her. Almost like a school, from school she was practicing martial arts and yoga.
On what basis you call this movie as the first martial arts movie of India?
Yeah, because I call it
we
that.
We have a Bollywood movie in 1983 which was named Karate. Yeah. And Vidyut Jamwal, Tiger Shroff, we have many stars who know martial arts. And
yeah. Yes. See, stars knowing martial arts is very different from a martial artist becoming an actor. The point is, none of them ever took place in tournaments. They were not a part of the martial arts, whatever community. I'm not saying no to that. That is one part. Let me finish the answer. Second part is, most of them, they use a lot of wire work. They do stunts, you know, going up in the air and things which no human being can actually do, because that is one kind of an action film. Whereas Bruce Lee is the only martial artist who always did something realistic. Only what he can do and what you see it in real life, you know, which is the reason I'm calling it the first martial art, because without taking the help of cinematic techniques and cinematic appliances, which is the reason I'm saying that.
Does your political stance or your tweets after 8 p.m.
Yeah.
does that affect you professionally? Because some of the your tweets have been created controversies and all about President candidate Draupadi Murmu.
Yeah.
Before that, about Pawan Kalyan.
See, first of all, I think this post 8 p.m. is a misnomer because I put tweets all time. One, just because I'm openly say that I drink vodka, they think it is that. Because actually, when I'm not having vodka, I'm more dangerous. You know, only that happens at that time because I'm done for I'm done with my work for the day, and also I kind of update myself about what's happening at that time, which is the reason sometimes it happens post 8 and not because of anything else. And with regard to what I tweet, I mean, as a free citizen of the country, I have my observations and comments to make on anything which is in the public domain and which exercise that right, yeah.
Actually, this movie is being like dubbed in South languages as well.
Yeah.
And you have been quite appreciative of the industry and you keep comparing with how it's better than the Hindi film industry right now. So what is it that the South industry is doing?
I mean, I really don't think it's South industry as a label. I would think it's more KGF2 has done that, actually. The Kannada film KGF2 is not supposed to be generalized as a South film, you know. I think, South film taking over North is a misnomer because South, I think between the four languages or five languages we have in the South, we make nearly 1,000 films a year, out of which we're only talking about 4 to 5 films which made a mark, you know. And but the point is the unexpectedness of a Kannada film becoming the biggest hit of all time in Indian cinema history. So KGF 2 is almost like a ghost now on top of Bollywood, you know. It is hovering over the thing and So I think I wouldn't like to use the word North and South. I think it's about films which make the difference. A particular individual film, no matter which language it comes from, is what which makes the difference.
Any artists from Kannada industry are
in
this film?
In this film? No. Because it's been primarily shot in Hindi.
You have been doing promotions in India and China. So, what was the response from Chinese to the movie?
See, China has got a fantastic response, which is the reason why it is releasing in 40,000 screens here.
Maybe highest for an Indian movie?
For Indian film, yes, definitely. The highest. And also, I think for a debut actor, this could be the first time in the world a film has been releasing in so many screens.
Sir, what do you think?
Which one?
Female audience.
My feeling is women will like this film more because women love to see men being beaten. I think. The fact that she's laughing is endorsing the point.
Arjivi, given the number of the speed at which you make movies, sometimes they are termed as experiments gone wrong. What do you have to say about that?
I mean, first of all, there's no connection with the speed and the way the film turns out. See, the longest time I've taken in my life to make a film, the most expensive film also, is probably Aag. And that is the biggest flop of my career. So I don't think there's any relation. And I took the shortest time to make a film and without any script in hand is Satya. So I don't think there's a correlation at all. Yeah.
Currently,
what
do you think is your, like, you know, kind of
a
status, or how do you see yourself as somebody in the film industry?
I mean, first of all, I got nothing to do with the film industry. I'm a filmmaker, an individualistic filmmaker. I make the kind of films I'm excited about. So I don't have any relationship to the film industry or to society or as such. Under the law of the land, whatever I'm wanting to do, how I want to live my life, and what I want to make, and what I want to say, I will do that.
Dangerous got some problem with while releasing.
Yes,
finally,
yes.
It got released or not?
No. It is going to release next month. Yeah.
So you continue to do experimental films, or you are trying to...
I mean, I don't know if it can be called experimental film. Continue to do films, because I think making the same kind of film all the time, that is more experimental than trying to make different films.
Your plans of doing mixed up films?
See, I don't think of it in that sense. What if the particular film requires a certain actor, in the script-wise and character-wise, I will do that. But I don't think of it in those terms of big or small. Whatever subject matter interests me, I make that.
Also, like, while talking about the release model, you have your own channel that's quite successful, right? Couple of movies are quite brilliant.
That's not true. See, I made some film for a certain channel. And COVID time, I had just a channel for short films, like under 40 minutes, 30 minutes. And otherwise, I don't have anything.
And what was the result of that? Like, do you think
the result was very good, because but that can't be taken as a business model, because of unusual times of lockdowns and all that. So that can't be really taken as a very specific workable model. But that can happen once in a while. It is just one more device that you have.
Somewhere I feel that my preparation for this film was not just for, you know, 2-3 years. My entire life has been a preparation for this film. When I met sir and we started shooting, so one thing was coming in my head again and again and in my heart that, you know, that I was born to do this film. And that's why, you know, this film is very special for me because it's my debut film in India and in China. So it's like a dream come true for any actor to, you know, to be associated with Sir. And I mean, the film is getting released on such a huge level. So that was really, you know, something very special.
Do you want to explore more regarding the zone, or you will stick to the action scene?
I would love to do more action films, like at least earlier in my career. After that, I really love action sci-fi films. So somewhere if I get to work in a sci-fi film, that will be really great.
Pooja, in real life, have you ever been teased by some guys and you breaking their bones in real life?
Fortunately, that have not happened with me yet. But there was one incident that I would want to, you know, mention, that I was going somewhere with my mother, and some guy, he was on the bike and he commented something on my mother. So I started running behind him and I almost, you know, caught him, but he, you know, he ran away. So that didn't happen. And I wish that, you know, थोड़ा चांस मिलता उसको बीट करने का. तो जो भी भड़ास थी मेरी टू बीट अ बैड गाय, वो मैंने पूरा फिल्म में वो भड़ास अपनी निकाल दी. एंड काफी फन आया टू यू नो टू फाइट विद गून्स. या
एज अ मार्शल आर्टिस्ट योरसेल्फ, हाउ इंपॉर्टेंट डू यू थिंक फॉर गर्ल्स टू लर्न मार्शल आर्टिस्ट और डिफेंस?
It's very important, and that is the message we are, you know, trying to send in the society, that how important it is in these days, because we are seeing so many criminal cases happening against women. So it's like, you know, that sense of awareness should be there. I'm not just saying ki you should join martial arts, but any kind of sport activity will give you that strength to, you know, lead a healthy life and do something different. Because if something unfortunate happens in your life, in any girl's life, then I think you should be able to protect yourself.
Please don't think this as a negative question. This is a serious question, because while shooting, have you ever thought itne chote kapde kyun pehna hai sabhi waqt? Kyunki jo bhi scenes humne on screen mein dekha, songs, trailer, so sabhi mein aisa hi tha. Isliye
I think I was, you know, not worried at all that what I'm going to wear in the film, because when we were planning the entire shoot of the action sequences, we gave it a really, you know, deep thought ki what kind of a clothes I should wear, whether, you know, it should be a sari or a bikini or jeans. So we have tried to cover all the different costumes to represent different kind of type of women in the society. We see some ladies wear sari, some wear jeans. So when sir told me that, you know, there's this idea that he has in his mind, that it will be very unique if a girl fights in a bikini, because we see a lot of heroines just coming out of water wearing bikini and doing poses. So this will be something unique if, you know, if we pull it off nicely. So that thought really intrigued me, and I immediately said yes, that, you know, sir, I'll do this sounds really amazing. I mean, we can, you know, do something new in all this time. So according to that, you know, I already started working on my body when we started the shoot. So I was like, why not? I've been working really hard on this body and to look in a certain way. So I would love to proudly show what I have achieved with my figure and with my physique. And that, you know, everybody's doing it. Every guy is doing this out there in the industry. All the action heroes and all kind of guys, they're just, you know, taking off their t-shirts and showing off their abs. So why, when a girl does it, we ask a lot of questions or term it as a bold and sexy scenes? I think we should just, you know, give that freedom, because the society, even society says that, you know, we should give education to women. So I think वहाँ तक सीमित नहीं है. There is more to that, you know, not just giving the education part, but there should be equal rights. There should be equal freedom of like what she wants to wear, she will wear, what she wants to do in her life, whatever she wants to achieve, she will achieve. So that motto was there in my mind that I don't care what society says about my clothes or what I'm doing or what kind of films I will choose in my future. I will do what my heart says and you know what is right for me.
You are all inspired girls to learn martial art?
Yes, ma'am. I think we are trying to inspire as many girls as possible, young and no matter what age they are. Whoever wants to join martial arts, I will, you know, tell them to go ahead and do it. And for those who can't join it, I think they can also protect themselves. They just need to listen to themselves and, you know, that fire is in every woman. So just if something like this happens in your life, just you know, use that willpower and protect yourself.
Puja,
your film inspired that.
Sorry, ma'am.
Your film inspired girls. Yeah.
Absolutely, in a lot of ways, not just in martial arts. I think the way I've portrayed my character, she's very strong woman, very independent woman. She does what she thinks is right. She takes the decision according to what her guru Bruce Lee used to, you know, say in his philosophy. So I think in a lot of ways girls will get inspired. I think guys too will get inspired.
Puja, for every sports person, our dream is that to represent their country. Do you ever think that I can be an artist or an actress?
I never thought that, you know, I'll you know, enter this industry. I always wanted to represent India in Olympics and win a lot of gold medals, but unfortunately that didn't happen. When I received my state award in 2014, my dad wanted me to join a government job, but I think God had some different plans for me. And I got a call from sir's office and my life just changed.
Yeah, now you are trying for Olympics or what? You having any thought for that?
I think now I'm I'm just aiming at something different and trying something very unique. When I started my journey in martial arts, I started from a scratch, and I'm doing the same thing here. You know, I'm just beginning, and let's see where it goes. I'm just here to stay. That is the only thing I know in my mind.
Haji sir, are you still in Rangila Rangila movie?
I mean,
similarity.
See, to start with, my first answer is I think I'll always be in Rangila Hangover, one point, you know, forever. And second is, I think that is how I would like to see, that's my vision as a filmmaker. But I think, having said that, the difference between Rangila and this is very stark, because Rangila there's about dancing, about you know, about showing off body. Here I think the fighting skill which you normally associate with a man, to see in a woman and to see the body in that context is a very, very different visual experience. Yeah.
So you cut off film you watched recently apart from KGF, which
impressed you? No, sir. I only watch KGF recent times.
So we are expecting from you, like Shiva, Rangila type of movie,
not
like...
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, but it will take maybe sometime in September. Yeah, September.
Do you think any
women
empowerment message is in this movie?
Yeah, I believe so. Because I think the primary point of the film is that the film is about a woman can do anything a man can do. I think that is the nearest definition of a women empowerment film. Yeah.
Arjun, you are a master of a lot of genres, like horror, gangster, films and all. But just taking back to the previous question about, like, we always keep talking about the short clothes, right? So if somebody were to say that the camera angles are quite voyeuristic, even though the genres are different, what would be your different to that?
I mean, see, voyeuristic is a very subjective question. See, my framing, whether I make a gangster film, whether I show a man or a woman or some character or a particular sequence, the way I shoot, it is my vision of how I would like to see that particular element in the film. So that is what makes me as an individualistic filmmaker. So I think it is just my expression of how I want to say something.